Physico-chemical properties and stability of dispersed systems. Let's look at this table. We can compare size of viruses which are close to colloidal particles which have colloidal size. I think it's very important nowadays. Friendly, firstly, classified dispersed systems into true solutions, colloidal solutions, and suspensions. This classification was based mostly on size of the particles. All dispersed systems consist of dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Colloidal solutions have particles small enough not to be settled and big enough to be classified as a heterogeneous particles. True solutions have the smallest particles, which are less than 1 nanometer. They are ions and molecules. Size of colloidal particles is between 1 and 100 nanometers, and suspensions have particles that are bigger than 100 nanometers. All these three types of solutions have different properties. For example, true solutions are homogeneous, whereas colloidal solutions and suspensions are heterogeneous. True solutions and colloidal solution particles may pass filter paper, but suspensions particles can't. Only true solution particles can go through cellophane paper, and colloidal and suspension particles, they can't. Colloidal systems are heterogeneous. They are multi-phases. They have several phases, and particles of these solutions are insoluble in solvent. All living cells contain particles of colloidal size. For example, blood is one of colloidal systems. One more classification of colloidal systems are based on aggregate state of dispersion medium and dispersed phase. As you see, gas-gas systems are not dispersed systems. They are true solutions. But all other types of colloidal systems are possible. Colloidal solutions may be classified according to interaction between dispersed phase and dispersion medium. They are lyophobic colloids and lyophilic colloids, and according to molecular size. Lyophobic colloids, they have affinity between phase and medium particles, whereas lyophobic colloids, they don't have any affinity between dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Macromolecular colloids. Example of them are protein solutions, starch solutions, etc. So dispersed phase in these colloids are big molecules, polymer molecules. Multimolecular colloids. Dispersed phase particles consist of huge amount of molecules or ions. And associated colloids, their particles consist of diaphilic molecules, which are not very big. Lyophobic salts are very easy to prepare. It's only mixture of dispersed phase and dispersion medium. They could be formed spontaneously. To prepare lyophobic solutions, difficult methods are used. They are physical and chemical methods, and both of them could be dispersion or condensation methods. In dispersion methods, big particles could be broken into small particles of colloidal size. Condensation methods are based on condensation of molecule or ions into bigger aggregates. Example of dispersion methods: mechanical grinding, electrical dispersion, peptization. Electrical dispersion is used to prepare zoles of metals mostly, whereas mechanical dispersion methods are used for other materials. Peptization. This is method when colloidal solution is made from fresh precipitate after addition to this precipitate some of compound which contain common ions. Chemical methods, they are condensation methods. Different types of reactions could be used to prepare colloidal solution. They are oxidation method, reduction method, hydrolysis, double decomposition, and other types of reactions. Here you could see some examples of mostly used reactions. Exchange of solvent or one of physico-chemical condensation methods. This method is used to prepare colloidal solution of compounds which are insoluble on water, but they are soluble in other solvents. For example, if we take alcohol resin solution and drop in water, mix it, we have ready colloidal solution of resin in water. We exchange of solvent for resin. It was alcohol and now it became water solution. Hydrophilic colloids are built from big molecules such as proteins molecules or starch molecules, and they are stable because of water coat around of them. Hydrophobic micelles have a bit different structure. Hydrophilic micelle structure we discussed previous lessons, and you could see some of example of hydrophilic micelles. Hydrophobic micelles, zol particles, consist of charged. They are charged particles. They are charged because of selective adsorption of common ions on this particle surface. Let's discuss silver iodide zol formation. It is physical condensation, chemical condensation method. We use this reaction AgNO3 plus Ki, and products of this reaction are KNO3 and AgI. To use chemical reaction for colloidal solution preparation, we should have first of all one of products insoluble. We have AgI. Concentration of reagent should be very low, and one of these reagents should be in excess to stabilize colloidal solution. Let's take Ki in excess first. Ki dissociate into solution into K plus and I minus ions. AgI is insoluble and it forms small particles in solution. On this particle surface, I ions will be adsorbed. It is selective adsorption of common ions. Particles became negative and they attract positive particles from solution, which are K-ions in our case. But number of K-ions adsorbed on particle surface is less. It's why this particle has negative charge. But in general, this structure should be negative. It's why we have some K plus ions in diffusion layer. So we have structure of silver iodide zol in which was prepared in excess of Ki. AgI is aggregate and I are potential ions which have same charge as a colloidal particle has. K ions are counter ions, and in general we have micelle structure. Here you see example of micelle structure which was prepared in excess of AgNO3. In this case, Ag plus ions are adsorbed on AgI surface. It's why charge of colloidal particle is positive. You could see both of these micelles. First of them on the left was made in excess of Ki, and the right one was prepared in excess of AgNO3. Left one is negative and right one is positive micelle. So, all particles in colloidal solution have electrical double layer. Because of these particles are charged, they wouldn't aggregate because they have same charge. All colloidal solution have special optical properties. All colloidal solutions show Tyndall effect. To compare coarse system suspension, they are cloudy, and ionic molecular true solution, they don't show any optical effects. On these pictures you could see this Tyndall effect or Tyndall cone, which colloidal solutions show. Electrokinetic properties. These are electrophoresis. It is moving of particles in electric field to oppositely charged electrode. For example, negative particles of clay will go to positive electrode, to anode. And electroosmosis. It is moving of dispersion phase liquid through porous body in electric field. Molecular kinetic properties are Browning motion, diffusion, sedimentation, osmotic pressure. Browning motion, it is a random moving of colloidal particles, which could be seen in microscope. These particles are moved because of molecules of dispersed phase. Diffusion, spontaneous process where particles go through from concentrated solution into dilute solution. Sedimentation or settling. Particles go down because of gravity. They precipitate. Purification methods of colloidal solution. When we prepare zols, they will contain some true solution particles which decrease their stability. It's why colloidal solution usually should be purified. Dialysis. Colloidal solution Colloidal solution is separated by membrane from water, and only true solution particles can pass this membrane. It's why colloidal solution will be purified from true solution particles. But this method is very long. It may take weeks or even months. It's why they use electrodialysis. It goes faster because of cations and anions go to oppositely charged electrodes. One more purification method is ultrafiltration. Again, here a membrane is used to purify this solution, but some other forces make this process faster. Why this is important for medical students and for medicine? Membrane is used for people who has problem with kidneys to purify the blood. This method is called hemodialysis, and membranes are used to separate blood from solution which does not contain these molecules which blood should be purified from. And again, these molecules go from place with their high concentration to low concentration, and blood could be purified. Disperse systems are not very stable because they have great surface area, and we may characterize their stability as a kinetic stability and aggregative stability. When colloidal particles aggregate and form bigger ones, they could sedimentate. This process is called coagulation. Clotting of blood is physiological process which is similar to coagulation. Coagulation of hydrophilic solution is reversible, and it takes part when water coat of particles is lost. And hydrophobic colloids coagulation takes place when they don't have electrical charge anymore. And this could happen when electrolyte solution is added to hydrophobic colloidal solution. This scheme illustrates coagulation of hydrophobic and hydrophilic solutions and their main reasons. In both cases, addition of salt provoke their coagulation, but in case of hydrophobic solution, salts decrease their charge and uncharged particles aggregate. In case of hydrophilic solution, these salt particles take their water coats. Coagulation could be caused by different processes such as heating, addition of salt, changing of pH, and etc. We will discuss now coagulation which take place because of salt's addition. Minimum amount of electrolyte which could be added to 1 liter of colloidal solution to coagulate it is called coagulation value or coagulation threshold. And the less this coagulation threshold, the bigger coagulating powder of this electrolyte. Coagulation threshold could be calculated according to this formula. In this formula, C electrolyte the electrolyte are concentration and volume of electrolyte. V-Zol is volume of Zol or colloidal solution. Units of coagulation threshold are mole per liter or more often millimole per liter. Hardy-Schultz law characterizes ability of different electrolytes to coagulate colloidal solutions. Effective ions or coagulating ions should have opposite charge to colloidal particles and their coagulating power increasing with increasing of their valency. Colloidal solutions could be stabilized by addition of polymer solution. These polymer molecules may adsorb on particle surface and prevent their aggregation. Gold number is used to characterize ability or protective ability of protein solutions, polymer solutions to protect colloidal solutions. Blood, as we say, is kind of colloidal solution. And on the left picture, you could see normal profile of red blood cells. You see all particles are separated from each other. And on the right picture, you could see result of blood cells clotting, process which is similar to coagulation. Colloidal solutions are used in medical practice. There are a lot of medicines which particles have colloidal size. And here are some examples of colloidal solutions which are used in medical practice.